first, let's bring in media writer for The Australian, Sophie Elsworth. Sophie, we all pay for our dearest ABC, yet for some reason they also advertise. Now, you revealed in The Australian that advertising has increased markedly. How on earth is this justified?
Well, Caroline, it's certainly a contentious issue. My story revealed that in the March quarter, the ABC spent $6 million on advertising, promotions and audience research, and about $3.8 million of that alone, Caroline, was on advertising just in the last quarter. This is a lot of money. I think many Australians would be concerned that the ABC is spending to advertise itself. For many would argue that they don't need to advertise. We pay for their content regardless. So why are they pouring millions of dollars every month into audience research, promotions and advertising? And is it necessary? So this data is quite concerning and shows that there has been increases in the March quarter compared to the previous March quarter. So I think if they're going to be transparent about this too, Caroline, they need to publish these figures in their annual reports, which they no longer do, and these figures are only able to be obtained via FOI.
Well, that's not really good enough. They absolutely should be more transparent. But do we know if this advertising actually works?
Well, Caroline, if you go on their figures, they are, just last week I wrote a story that their radio audiences are diminishing. They had radio audience falls in their three key markets in Brisbane, Sydney and Melbourne. And we know that their TV audiences are also falling. So you could argue perhaps this isn't working, but I think perhaps they need to look at their spending and see, because they're always crying poor, the ABC, is it necessary to be spending money on advertising what Australians already pay for?
Entirely possible. Also, the advertising could just be stemming the flow. And, you know, it's not just the ABC, but all broadcast networks are facing challenges managing the changing habits of younger demographics who, as we know, Sophie, skew heavily towards digital platforms. But how stark is that change?
Well, a report came out this week, Caroline, that the audience numbers have declined by 83% in terms of how much, should I say, people are watching content. So teenagers back in 2011 were consuming about 75 minutes a day of TV content, and that has now fallen to 13 minutes. Now, as we know, Caroline, a lot of people have changed the way that they view content. A lot of people are streaming content when it suits them. They're not sitting down with their evening meal and watching programs at designated times. So this is a real challenge for all networks, is to make sure that they can keep capturing these audiences, but also catering for people who don't want those rigid timetables to watch the shows that they love.
And I suppose that's the point going forward. How quickly and easily are broadcast networks adjusting to this very, very significant change?
Well, I would argue that they're adapting to it pretty well, because we have very good streaming services in Australia. Australians love to stream. They will pay for their content. You know, a lot of households have multiple streaming platforms, whether they are paid or free. So I think Australians can adapt. The broadcasters have adapted to it. But, you know, this impacts their bottom line too. So they have to keep these viewers, particularly those that other than the ABC and SBS, because they rely on advertising dollars, and they need to keep those viewers so that they get the advertising dollars as a result.